Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. It took a while to load. Get out of my way. Okay. You probably realize this by now, but there is no star key in the tower whatsoever. I'm gonna switch to Goombella just to get a little ahead on this something here. Anyway, to get the star key, you've got to go down this route right here. You could actually do this before the tower if you would like to. In fact, a lot of people do that because, you know, you just go from here and you go back over to the tower. Wait a second, you're new. Why am I ignoring you? You are new! I must do something about that. As in, I must tattle you. This is a dark wizard! It's a part machine, part organic, centuries-old thing. Max HP is 10, attack is 5, and defense is 2. It uses magic to attack and to alter your condition, so stay on guard. If there's only one left, it'll multiply itself to confuse you. I know they look totally goofy, but they're actually pretty tough enemies. Yeah, they are, and I'm just gonna start off by normal hammering sucker. You might actually want to have the Feeling Fine badges equipped. Aww. In this situation, you would probably want to do an Earth Tremor. But I'm tempted to run from this battle just to save myself the star power because a boss is coming up. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah, and as you can tell, if I just use the Earth Tremor, that battle would pretty much be done unless I failed the Earth Tremor, which is always a possibility with me. But but what I'm saying is that it's not that big of a deal, actually. It's not that dangerous of an enemy. You know how to deal with the wizard type of enemies. Oh! I knew you were there! I just didn't know where. So I gotta move very cautiously forward through these hallways of doom. By hallways of doom, I mean they're not all that lot dangerous, actually. isn't there something else? Most of the time, there's really nothing here.
We're inside of the Palace of Shadow. This is another corridor. Big surprise. You better watch below our feet as well as above our heads. You know what I mean? But, don't forget the area above your head, too. Does that make any sense?
So, just keep going on and keep going on. Yeah, you just keep going on like this. And I already got the tattle of you. Just keep going down the hallways. It's long, I know. And when you reach a save block, this is where you prepare yourself for the doom ahead. I'm pretty well prepared, so let's just go in. Alright, what do we have in here? Who are you? Hooktail 2.0! No one's disturbed me in here in aeons. Who dares defile this sacred place?
Hey, isn't that Hooktail? We totally beat it before. What's it doing back?
What? You destroyed my precious younger sister. Sister! Dun dun dun! Yeah, Hooktail is actually a girl. This is the first and only point in the game where they refer to Hooktail as a sister, as a female. So, yeah, they kind of hint that Hooktail is a male for the whole time, and then you get to this point, and then BAM! Plot twist! I wonder why she had written recently. Quake in fear, immortals, for I am Gloomtail. I will avenge my sister by taking your lives and then gnawing on your bones. Bring it on! My first fresh meat in ages. Allow me to take my time and toy with you a while. Alright, so we got a bonus at the start. We're gonna get an even bigger bonus here. Power lift right off the bat, because it's incredibly handy to boost your defense against something with such an high attack power. So, oh shoot, no! Freaking slow down. No, I failed by hitting poison. Oh, I think it'll be okay. I just need to get faster! Oh, poison mushrooms left and right. Well, that's not bad, I guess. Could be better, but I hit the poison. Alright, now let's do a tattle on Gloomtail. Don't think I forgot about the tattle. Come on now, this isn't the pit of 100 trials.
That's Gloomtail. I think he's Hooktail's brother. I see the family resemblance. Max HP is 80, attack is 8, and defense is 2.
That's why I wanted to boost my defense.
He'll bite or stomp you, and he may also breathe poison on you. Great. When his HP gets low, he may throw in some other attacks as well. Wouldn't surprise me. Especially watch out for his Mega Breath move, because the word is it's gnarly. He also stores power for some attacks, so use Vivian to hide to avoid those.
Yeah, so it's very, very, very similar to the Hooktail battle at first, other than the poisoning. You probably want the Feeling Fine badges on for this battle, but it's not necessary, really, in my opinion. I'm just gonna knock down its defense points, and let's do a multi-bonk! Oh, poopers. That's all I got out of the multi-bonk. Oh, I am timing my guards very badly there. he can do a lot of damage to you, so try and keep your HP in the double digits, if at all possible. If it powers itself up, then you most certainly want to switch to Vivian and have her use her Veil move to guard you completely. Alright, let's see what... I'll just do a normal hammer. My attack power is high enough, and I knocked the defense down. Yeah, everything should be fine in my calculations. Alright, multi-bonk! It's kind of weird timing it on him, because the hitbox moves as he jiggles as you're hitting him, and yeah. You are tough meat, my little tasty morsels, but how will you fare against this? Got lucky there. Alright, well, Mario's okay, I guess. I should probably start switching over to Vivian somewhere around here. Maybe, might be, well, let's just do this. Do that first, and then switch over to Vivian. There we go. I'm doing a terrible job guarding that attack, that's fine. The poison really isn't one of the more dangerous status ailments, because, you know, it just takes away 1 HP per turn, and you can take that into consideration with your calculations. Give me that mushroom! Thank you. Alright, maybe what I should do is another power lift, because my stats drop back down. It's nice to have the defense back up. This time, no poison, PkGam. Watch that poison. Okay, I'm talking to myself. But then again, I do that in every video, don't I? Just a regular old video to you guys. Alright, now that's a boost. Yeah! Alright, since I don't really have anything to multi-attack, Shade Fists! Yeah. And it's burned.
You're not the easy prey you appear to be. I would never be able to show my face again if I was bested by you, whelps. So I will show you the true extent of my power.
Yep, he just raised his attack power by 8. And this is the time that you want to use Vivian's Veil move. But you can, of course, attack with Mario normally before you use Vivian's Veil if you'd like to. But just make sure that your HP is sufficient enough when you come out of the Veil move, because, you know, when you come out of the Veil move, he's going to attack instantly.
Mega Breath!
And that'll do a lot of damage.
Do you understand my true power now?
No, I just dodged it completely. You just embarrassed yourself there. And oh, it's doing it again, huh? That's inconvenient. That's fine, though, I guess. I wonder if I should soft stomp him when I have the chance a little bit later on. Alright, B-A. Very easy veil there.
How can this be?
Because your attacks are easily dodgeable. Yep.
Oh!
Alright, I wonder if I should. Another power lift, maybe? Could be. Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. I'm just thinking of the HP that I have and whatnot. I'm trying to avoid using items if at all possible, because items, you might not have the same items that I have, you know, even though that you kind of come across them in the Palace of Shadow and whatnot. Yeah, you get what I'm saying here. I mean, you might use them, is, yeah, what I'm saying. Alright, there we go. I can live with that. Shade Fists.
Wah! Wah!
Stylish. And you're powering yourself up again, good lord. Uh-oh, stage hazard! It missed me. I could actually probably finish it off. Because I've, because I can attack it freely with both Mario and Vivian. Now let's do that.
No. No. Is it true? Can I expire?
Nah, no one dies in a Mario game. That's preposterous.
Woo!
Goes belly up. Ah, you'll be fine. Do not get that chest just yet. Do not get it just yet. Trust me. Go past the chest. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Go inside. This spooky hallway into this secret passage for an Ultra Shroom and a Jammin' Jelly. Oh, yeah. Is there anything else secret in this room here? Well, she might be referring to that chest, so that might be a bad time to use her sniffer here. But usually she, you know, closes her eyes and gets really antsy when something's nearby. Like that. See that? But yeah, grab this chest and you'll get the star key. Or I should say open this chest and you'll get the star key. And yeah, there you go. See? Gloomtail is just fine. He's just twitching. Just a couple of mushrooms. He'll be good to go again. So we'll just leave him here. Oh, he's still there. I had a feeling that he might just, like, vanish completely or something like that, but no, didn't happen. I thought that might have happened, but I guess not. Alright, with the defeat of Gloomtail, I'm gonna end off this part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part.